let's go to the next one, which is CMake. So this is one of the ones that I'm going to rebuild because it's got this graphic-y type stuff, all the Qt options. So let's make a note of that as well. Rebuild CMake after Qt. Some version in there as well. Okay, so let's go back here. Let me mark off libuv as complete. Libuv. And CMake is under 13 programming. So let's download that. And save the disk. So let's just check the commands. Systemlibs is there. So no system JSON CCP. They don't want that because the bundled versions is used. So we need to add. Oh no, we don't, sorry, we don't need this because we haven't got Qt. So when we built Qt and we come to rebuild CMake, then we had that switch there. Okay, so let's copy these commands in preparation. Let's paste the commands in, and this takes about 10 minutes or so, judging by the number of SBUs. Okay, so that wasn't even 10 minutes, but that's not a problem. So let's test it now. Now just reading here, it says got this command to type in, and you've got to put the number of calls in to make a parallel test. And it says, in case the environment variable lang is set to non-blank value and failures occur, try running the test without having lang set. So I'm going to try running it with initially. And obviously if it fails, I'll just run it again with lang. Just set to blank or even unset. Probably set to blank would be easiest. And it says to run cmake command line ties, no to fail if said standard package is not installed. Now, I seem to remember that that package is now part of Linux from scratch standard install, so that shouldn't be a problem. So let's copy this command. I'll just make this all visible. Back to the command prompt, let's paste that in and change this to 4 and see what happens. So it looks like there's 515 tests, stages at least. Okay, well, that looked like everything's passed, so obviously Lang didn't make a difference there. Maybe there's some permutations of Lang that affect the tests. So let's install that now. And that's complete. So let's mark that one off. And now we're into LLVM. So again, this is going to be another rebuild. Rebuild LLVM after Oxygen, etc. Okay, so we've got a few downloads here on this one. Let's just tidy up this one here. CMake. And LLVM is another programming one. There it is there. What does it say here? Okay, so let's download the package. Okay, this is quite a big package of the looks of it. It's not only a big archive, fairly big archive, it takes quite a while to build as well. So I've got two optional downloads, so let's grab those as well. Okay, so let's start by extracting LLVM. LLVM. So if you have downloaded the optimal packages, install them into the source tree by running the following commands. So we've done that. So let's extract both of them. And it looks like it moves what's extracted into certain locations. Okay, that's all done. Fix a problem introduced by glibc if you're using compiler RT, which we are. So is this big sed command. That's done. Now install LLVM by running the following commands. So let's take a quick look at any options. LFI. Lib, type equals release, targets to build. Oh yeah, we're going to have to change that. Do I lib on? RTTI on? Shared libs on? Instead of LLVM, builds all the shared libraries instead of static. Okay, I'm not sure what effect that would have, so I'm not going to bother with that. And enable doxygen, we haven't got that. So the only one we need to look at is this one here. The switch enables building for the same target as the host and also for the R600 AMG GPU used by the Mesa R600 and Radiant SI drivers. The BPF target is required to build video for Linux utils. Default is all. Use a semicolon to separate this. Valid host site x86, Spark, PowerPC, etc. Now I think the best ones to go for that I've used are, well, I haven't got AMD GPU at all, so obviously the AMD GPU is redundant for my case because I've only got Intel. So I think the x86 and the BPF ones are the ones I need. Let me just cross-reference that with one of my existing builds just to double check that. Just bear with me a moment. Right, I've only used BPF and x86, or was it separate host? This switch enables using, okay, so host is a valid target, okay, yeah. So, what I need to do then is to copy this command. To there, let's just check that we've done the other bits. Yeah, we did the sed. So let's paste that in. So I need to change this. Obviously, you're going to have to change this to reflect your own hardware. I need to change this to x86. It says there, just there. So I've got host, the default host target, the x86 and BPF to allow me to use video for Linux utils if I need that. And I'll copy the rest of that command now. So I'm just going to copy that there and just double check it. So CC equals G, CCXX equals G plus plus C make. Host semicolon BPF. Test on adf ninja dot dot. Okay. Okay, so let's run Ninja to build it. Okay, so that has built successfully. So we can take a look at the next bit. So next one's for installing the documentation, but we haven't got this Sphinx package. It's actually offline, but and so is the recommon mark. So we can't do that. And documentation for the optional packages. So to test results, issue ninja check all. So is there any indication of how long the test might take? 5.5, so not quite as long as the build. Tests are built with all available cores but run using the number of online processors. Difference is that available cores can be limited using task set, but taking them offline requires echoing 0.2. That's sys devices. And sanitizer based tests, 387 more than 38,000 tests run are known to fail. So we'll just run this and see what happens. Okay, so it says, it's done 126 tests, and it looks like it's got a lot more to do. 52,000 tests now, so we'll just wait for them to finish. Okay, so as was mentioned in the book, several tests and known to fail. I'm not sure whether there was an indication of how many. If this is the number of tests, it looks to be fewer than 387 there. It's probably just over a screenful. There's no way of knowing. There's no mention of how to view the failures, so just, you know, there's nothing else here. So I'd say that's probably more successful than 387 failures when you consider that from there, sorry, so from there to there is one failure. Doesn't really look to be 387, so it's probably a lot better than it warns here. Certainly there was more than 38,000 tests. I think it's on like 54,000. So that's probably a lot better than expected. So let's install the package. Sorry, Ninja install. Another thing with the test, right up front, when it was preparing the test, it was warning about certain things not being in place and that tests would fail. So looking through some of the errors reported did seem to tie up with that initial error report. So we didn't build any documentation. There's any configuration to look like it. So that looks like LLVM is complete. So let's mark that off. And it's marked for rebuild as well. And get rid of that one and move on to Mesa.